peace be upon you. I was awaiting for you to arrive. I'm sure you can sense the evil that is spreading ruthlessly upon the souls of the people of the Earth. I have no hidden agendas or personal interests. I don't plan to manipulate, trick, or deceive you. I merely hope to enlighten you towards a truth. We live at a time where people are being set upon a false path, one that corrupts their minds with sin and disbelief. Evil is hunting down more and more people as I'm talking to you right now. It is like a hungry beast that feeds on dragging us to pain, misery, and suffering. But we need to ask ourselves, who is it to blame? Our Almighty God created each one of us as a unique individual. He blessed us with hearts to feel His presence, eyes to see His magnificent creations, and ears to hear His message. But overwhelmed by the temptations of this materialistic world, we turned our backs on our Creator and betrayed the purpose of our existence. Instead, we use our eyes to look at what takes us away from Him. Our hearts love what God hates. Our ears listen to what goes against His beautiful teachings. We use the blessings of our Creator to satisfy our own selfish desires. We have become experts in material goods and worldly affairs, but completely ignorant in matters of the hereafter. This has caused our souls to suffer a slow death. We have become heedless. Our heedlessness about God has torn us apart. Rather than being filled with love and kindness, we have become sources of evil and hate. Heedlessness is a disease that does not only harm you as an individual, but it also spreads its pain to your fellow man. You need to ask yourself, has your time not yet come? Isn't this the perfect moment to strive towards God and repent your sins? To you who can hear me, I encourage you to listen to the voice of your screaming soul, yearning for a glimpse of salvation. It is telling you that this is the perfect moment to strive towards God. It is the perfect moment to repent your sins. This is the time for change. The Holy Quran in chapter 13, verse 11 says, "Indeed, God will not change the condition of a people until they change what is in themselves." Let us all unite to stop the wars we are launching against each other and begin the war against the real enemy, the enemy within. Let us all start a global battle against our evil habits, evil sins, and evil traits. Let us purify our souls and illuminate the earth with our divine light. It doesn't matter what your skin color is or how much wealth you have. The way to God can unite us all under the One who created us all. So let us strive together, work together, and fight together to be the change we want to see in the world. You can repent your sins, and finally, heaven will be your abode. This is the way to God. Enter in peace.